Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, I took the cell out of the car yesterday, so now it's at room temperature. And the water's still in it, so I'm going to take the water out and drain it into here. And we're going to see if we got heavy water or not. Okay. Well, let's go ahead and put my cheesecloth over there. My ice cubes out of the way. And then I'm going to take this connection off here and drain it. Okay. Now, go ahead and drain the fuel cell. Oops.
Take a look at that water.
Mm-hmm.
Water coming out.
Supposedly it's heavy water. I didn't get a whole lot, did I? Can you tip the fuel cell this way so it drains? Pull it this way, tip it over. There you go, keep going.
Look at that water coming out of the fuel cell.
We're gonna reuse this water.
Yeah, that's why we're filtering it. That's heavy water we have there.
Hopefully it's heavy water. We're going to check it real quick here. Okay, let's stop. Okay. Now. That drain.
It's ferrous oxide you got there.
Yep, that's the yarn coming out of the stainless.
Stainless, 304 stainless. Look at that. Dirt. Look at the water we got here.
Alright. Now we're going to try dropping an ice cube in this thing and see if it floats. Hopefully we'll be able to see this ice cube.
Now when the ice floats.
I'm going to tip it this way so you can see it. Here goes the ice cube. Ready? Boink. Oh, it floats. It's still floating.
Yeah, the ice floats.
So we still don't have heavy water. After running it for a year, still floating. I don't know if you can see it or not. Still floating, so it's not heavy water. And that water's been in there for a year being electrolyzed. Okay, anyway, I'm still going to reuse this myself, so I'm going to cap that off. Alright. Okay, now we're going to tear this sucker apart and see what we got. Splashed on your feet. Okay. Here we go. First time the cell's been apart in a year.
It's been a year, huh?
Yep. In a year inside of the vehicle. Never been apart.
Happy birthday.
Where the screw can put it both of them.
It used to be stainless, but I guess right now it's stain lesser or stain more.
Go any further, I gotta go out and wash my hands.
This fuel cell has been used for more than a year, and it had given a 35% savings. 35%
all over the place now.
No recording. Disassembling the hog after a year use in a Revel. Toyota Revel 2.4 diesel engine. Thank you. Here we go. Whoa, that's ugly.
Yep, that's 304. Just wonder how much reaction you're getting off of that, right? Let's watch this.
It's after 1 year of use.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, actually, you're not getting that. Your reaction from this side, right? Watch, you watching this?
Nothing happened. Did change color, but since that didn't penetrate through the 304. Wow, look at that.
At that color.
This is, I think, the oxygen side, right?
Yep. And this is the hydrogen side over here.
Yeah, this is the oxygen
this
side.
This would be the positive.
Yeah, the positive plate.
Side of it.
Look at the negative plates.
That's the negative side of the plate.
Yeah, this
the other side of the plate would be the positive. Mm-hmm.
This is where the hydrogen is being made.
Mm-hmm.
Inside the cell.
And you take it, you flip it over, and it's going to be black on that side.
Yeah.
See that?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Nice. Oh. Look at all the buildup on this. That's from 304 stainless, friends. 304. We don't want 304. And to imagine my it was doing as good as it was doing.
Yeah, let us remind everybody that 304 is a kind of stainless.
Mm-hmm.
And for now we don't recommend using it because just look at what happened to it after a year of use. And you think that production has been lesser because of this. You use 304, that's what happens after 1 year inside a fuel cell. You recommend having it nickel plated or use 316L.
Yep.
Oh, look at that.
Mm-hmm. Look at that, baby. Woohoo!
That's
1 year.
The hydrogen side.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
See? Hydrogen doesn't really have effect on stainless.
The oxygen side.
The oxygen side, look at that. It's 1 year. That's a lot of cleaning to do.
Clean this all up, put it back in, and use it again until we get 316L or nickel.
So, never submerge it in a acid thing again.
No, don't acid bag.
Don't feed it with acid because you're going to fuck up the stainless in it.
Is it this here? Look at this. Okay. Where's my hole? Look at my holes, all plugged up.
The positive side and the negative side.
Each plate has a positive and negative side.
Yeah. The oxygen side is the black part where oxidation is replaced. That's what happens when oxygen and the element called iron, ferrous.
This is a positive lead coming to this one, so this is shitty on both sides.
Yeah. That's
about all I'm gonna do for now. I'm gonna let it dry up. Let it dry and I'll clean it.
So what happens to the rubber? Become brittle?
No, don't break my gasket.
Nothing. There's nothing wrong with the gasket.
Nothing wrong with the gasket except this little warp
just the plate.
Squished.
Anyway, it's been a year.
Yep. Look at that.
It's been a just compensation for...
Look at this.
The HHO it produced.
So much in the bottom hole there, you can't see it. Halfway through the cell. Look at that. Look at all this in the cell that my magnet didn't collect. Oh, baby. Want some? Yummy. That's all the stuff that my cell was in my cell for a year.
Yeah. It went to the middle. How do you think that happened?
It's not getting out, that's all. Hang it on the other side.
Can you repeat that?
The neutral plates all have a positive side, which is oxygen, and that collects all the stuff, and then you have the negative side, which makes hydrogen, and that's your cleanest side.
And, as you can see here, this is the positive plate. Both sides are dirty. See?
And there's the last. Oh, no. But I'm going to save that for a later date here.
Mañana. Anyway, after 1 year of using your Toyota Revo.
Yeah, we did a volume test with being this bad, and we got 1 liter and 42 seconds.
We made the volume test before we dismantled this, disassembled this fuel cell, and we got approximately a liter and 40 seconds. That's in this condition. Now look at that, what happened to the hydrogen oxygen generator? It's dead.